How do I get transformed into the likeness of Christ? By the renewing of my mind, and thereby I prove what is the perfect will of God. In the Old Covenant, God spoke from outside. Abraham, Samuel, do this, do that, do the other, because God was outside. But from the day of Pentecost, God came inside. The Holy Spirit's inside, and He speaks from inside. And there, as I allow God to renew my mind, in different situations, I prove what God's will is for my life. And when we think of God's will, we think of what job I should take, whom I should marry. Those are not the primary things. They're important, but they're secondary. The primary things is, what should be my attitude to this sin? What should be my attitude to this thing? What should be my attitude to so many things in this world which don't please God? That is where I need to have my mind renewed to think like God thinks. And if I want to think like God thinks, it's a legitimate paraphrase of my renewing of my mind and being transformed. To begin to think like God thinks, like Jesus thinks, I need to be saturated with Scripture. Because this is the only book in the whole world that tells me how God thinks. Even the Old Testament. I read the Old Testament passages like Hosea and Joel and all that, and I see God's tremendous hatred of sin. Of idolatry, for example. How He condemned those Israelites for idolatry. And the biggest idolatry today is the worship of money. And God hates it. If I see that, I say, Lord, I want to hate it too. I want to use it, but I don't want to worship money. I don't want to worship pleasure. I don't want to worship anything, because God hates idolatry. So there, as I read the Bible, I begin to see the things that God hates. He hated adultery. He hated fooling around with the opposite sex. He believed in the sanctity of marriage. Malachi says in chapter 3, God says, I hate divorce. So, chapter 2, sorry. So, as I read the scriptures, I begin to think like God thinks about the different subjects that I'm facing in the world today. That's the renewing of my mind, where I begin to think like God thinks, then I can prove what is God's perfect will. So I was telling you about John chapter 5, how Jesus came by the pool of Bethesda, and His mind was always thinking about how the Father thinks. Father said, heal this one man and go. And He went. What I wanted to point out to you further in John chapter 5 was, afterwards Jesus met this man. In John 5 verse 14, this man whom He had healed, He met him in the temple, and Jesus told him, John 5:14. Now you have become well. Don't sin again. Otherwise something worse will happen to you. What do you get from that? That his paralysis was due to sin. That's why he was sick for 38 years. And Jesus said, don't sin again. So there's a case of a sickness that was due to sin. Now you go to John chapter 9 and you read of another man who was blind.